guys, and thanks for joining me again on another Campfire Chat. Again, welcome to the woods. Welcome back to my old subscribers. Welcome to my new subscribers. And I hope you enjoy the content so far, and I hope you'll stick with me and like and subscribe. So you'll have to excuse me, guys. It's a hot, beautiful day out today. I'm going to have a cool frosty while I chat with you today. Oh, yeah. So today's talk, I've decided, is going to dovetail in with my what I'm taking to Duck Mountain video for this week. So this week's topic is my thoughts on navigation, some equipment you should be familiar with, and some general concepts about it. Again, like I said in all my videos, I'm not trying to really teach you guys anything per se. If you guys want me to go more in depth into this, I can always go more in depth into this. Just leave a comment down below or hook up with me through a private message and I can do a video series on navigation. But for the most part right here, right now, I will say that there are others out on the interwebs that you can find that can do a much better job of explaining it right here, right now than I can. I'm just going to give you my general thoughts and let you guys make the decision from there. Because after all, I'm just a guy in the woods. These are just my thoughts and my ideas. And it's up to you guys to do with it what you will. All right. So moving right along. I'm going to start off with a story. All right. This is what I always remember. Because you don't know how easy it is to get lost in a small space until you actually get lost. So I was a young man, roughly about 13, 14, where I grew up in Nova Scotia. It's wooded, pretty much like this. And again, the woods all look the same, right? So for 5 years, I'd been cutting through this one trail to get to the bus stop and back. It was a hike. It was about a 500-600. No, it was more than that. I'd say close to a kilometer hike to get to the bus. And it was through trees, woods like this. It was usually a nice walk. And, well, one day someone decided to put a house right smack dab in the middle of our favorite trail that we'd all been using forever to go to the bus stop. So we were forced to go around and find a new trail. Again, not a big deal. I grew up in this area my entire life. At this point in time, it was about 13, 14 years. I knew those woods like the back of my hands. I didn't need a map. I didn't need a compass. I didn't need any of that stuff. What could go wrong? I'm only 15 minutes from my house and the bus stop's only a kilometer up the road. What could go wrong? Well, getting there was not a problem because it was daylight. So I just kind of bush bashed and bushwhacked my way through the woods and never really thought of anything of it. Took mental note because everyone's memory is crystal clear and perfectly photographic. So what I did is not a problem. So coming home, unfortunately, in the dark. So it was a little bit later in the year, so it got dark early. So I got off the bus. I followed my normal trail where I normally go, and then I took my new trail, my new branch that I had to find. Well, coming home wasn't exactly as easy as going to. Now, you have to understand, this patch of woods, maybe 500 square meters, if that. Old growth East Coast forest, so it was pretty thick, pretty dark, but still, only a small patch of woods. Well, guys, I got turned around in that small patch of woods for must have been about 3 hours. Every time I'd try to find a way out, I would just literally walk in circles. And I never thought that was a thing. I was like, how can anyone walk in circles when they're lost? That's ridiculous. You pick a direction, you walk towards it. I tell you, until you've actually walked in circles because you're lost, you don't really know. So ever since I eventually found my way out. I eventually walked in one straight direction, making sure that, you know, I kept something in the distance to orientate myself. And I just walked post to post to post to post until I finally made it out. Pretty far from my original entry point too, I might add. But ever since that, and that's always rung true with my mind. And like I said, I'm going on 48 years old now. And I always remember the time when I got lost. Since then, I've made sure never to get lost. And that's what today's about. Just some general concepts and some good ideas and some good tips that you guys should know when you're going to be doing stuff like this and you're going to be venturing into the woods. All right. So the first thing we're going to do is a map. Okay. This is the map I'm going to take to Duck Mountain, as well as a roamer. For those of you who don't know, this is a roamer. You can find them in all kinds of different shapes, different sizes. Primarily, it's designed to measure angular measurement on a map. All right, so they can either be round or square. But really the big thing with the roamer that you're looking for is you're looking for the scales. The scales will assist you in picking grids off of a map. So first thing you should always bring is a roamer or something thereof. It doesn't have to look like this, but it should be something. And if that means there's a roamer on your compass and you choose to use that, then that's a thing. It's one less piece of equipment you have to worry about. I myself prefer to have the separate scale with the dot in the middle so I can mark my spots and mark where I'm going. Much easier. It gives me a better accuracy. So the next thing I have is a map. This is my map for Duck Mountain. It doesn't really matter wherever you're going. You should always have a map of the area. At the bare minimum, just a simple 1 to 50,000 topo map. It could even be a photocopy if that's your thing, if the area is small enough. As long as it shows grid lines and it shows all your appropriate information that you need it to show, your trails, your roads, your contours, etc., your elevations, etc., etc. And that brings me to my next point is maps. Not only should you bring one, but you should also be conversant in how a map works. You should know the basic jargon. You should know the information that your map shows. You should be able to perform simple things like pick a grid off of a map, identify your location on a map using dead reckoning and using prominent objects. If you can't do that, you should be able to resection, perform triangulation to find your way on a map. You should know all the basic layout of a map. And you should do all this before you go into the woods. You should perform your own little map recce prior to going into the woods so you're familiar with what you're going to look at. The last thing you want to do is have your map, you know, open your map the first time ever when you're lost. You want to be aware of it. Also, if you don't get a map that's printed on Tyvek to make it waterproof, ensure you have a plastic sleeve or a plastic bag to keep your map dry. Because, again, a map that's nothing but a balled up wad of soaking wet paper is worth absolutely nothing. The next piece of stuff you guys should have is a compass. And you should be aware of the basic parts of a compass and how to utilize a compass in relation to a map. You should understand about declination, how to set declination and be accurate with your measurements. You should know how to plot a bearing with on a map. You should know how to march on a bearing with a map. You should understand the concept of bearing, back bearing. And again, like I mentioned before, knowing how to do a resection utilizing your compass and your map is always a good skill to know. Again, your map will come with roamers already on it. So you don't have to bring the extra piece of equipment if you don't want to. But I find without the hole in the middle and not being not being able to mark my points to be extremely not good in my regard. I prefer to be able to mark the map precisely using the roamer. Your compass is going to have look either more complicated than this or less complicated than this. It doesn't matter what type of compass you have. The only thing that matters is you know how to use it and you know how to use it well. So your map and your compass are your two most basic pieces of equipment that everyone should carry. The basics. Once you're done with the basics and you know how to use the basics, you can use technology to complement you on this. But you shouldn't use technology as your primary method. You should always use a map and a compass as your backup. Batteries die. That's just a fact of life. Stuff gets wet. You drop it. So always know how to use a map and compass. But something that greatly helps your aids in navigation is a GPS. All right? It doesn't matter whether your GPS is a watch. It doesn't matter if it's a handheld unit that you normally see people use. It can even be your phone. But having a GPS or some method to quickly find your location and be able to quickly plot a bearing and be able to follow it easily is a godsend. Also, even if you're not using this as your primary means of navigation and you're using your map and compass like you should be using, this is always a good check whenever you're confused or unsure of your location or you just want to double check to make sure you're going in the right way. So GPS should be another aid to navigation, but not your primary means of navigation. And for me, finally, the last piece of navigation equipment, and this I hope to never use, an emergency beacon. If for whatever reason, your GPS batteries die, your phone dies, your map gets soaked, you break your compass, you've always got that one last Hail Mary. And again, this is one of those things that you hope never to ever have to use again. The benefit to this is, again, it's a Garmin InReach Mini 2. It's a satellite communicator, so no matter where you are in the world, this will work. You will be able to get your locations off of it. And if for some reason everything else dies, gets wet, gets lost, breaks, you've always got your one last hit. Before you're absolutely lost and ready to give up, you always got that one last button to hit, and that will bring help to you, or at least get you in contact with help so that you can find out where you are and possibly arrange for rescue. Now, guys, I just went over, it's going on 13 minutes here, 14 minutes. I just went through all the navigation aids and my thoughts on navigation. You can find this information, again, all this information about how to use a map, how to use a compass, parts of a compass, how to properly use a GPS, yada, yada, yada. You can find all this information on YouTube. There's plenty of books. I know books are passe in today's day and age, but there are plenty of books written on this topic. And again, ultimately it all, you can always go find a local orienteering group, local search and rescue, or a youth organization, or a outdoor organization that will teach you these skills. I can't stress enough how important navigation is. It's just as important, if not more, than any of the other piece of equipment. Because what's the point in coming out here to enjoy yourself if all you're going to do is walk in circles for 3-4 hours? Know your area, do your homework beforehand, make sure you have the necessary navigation aids and the necessary navigation equipment before you even leave the house. And hopefully you never even have to use it. All right, guys. Thanks again for stopping by and listening to my rant and my thoughts. If you like this stuff, like, subscribe, and ring the bell to get my so that you can be notified when I release new content. For any new subscribers, welcome. This is my Tuesday campfire chat video. It's mostly just me talking and doing stuff. If you like this stuff, mention it to your friends, bring them over. They can like and subscribe, and then we can have a conversation and hopefully grow the channel. All right, guys, thanks again. And we'll see you on the next video for my Duck Mountain playlist. All right. Cheers.